This is me, Garima Singh. I hope you all are doing well. Let's move on to the fourth chapter. Basically, we're discussing the solution of the questions. For crux of these chapter, I make a separate video. Now I'm just discussing question and answer of this one. So the fourth chapter is distribution of ocean and continents. So let's just, without wasting time, let's jump to the question part. So, first question is who, I think we are done with this one or not? No, we have to discuss. So, let's discuss the question part. This is about the solution of this chapter. Question is, who amongst the following was the first to consider the possibility of Europe and America having been located side by side? C. Abraham Ortler. Then polar swing force relates to rotation of the earth. So it should be C. Then which one of the following is not a minor plate? So Antarctica is not the minor plate. Then these all are minors. Which one of the following fact was not considered by those while discussing the concept of sea floor spreading? So distribution of fossil in different continents. This was not considered while other was considered, like volcanic activity, ocean ridges, stretches of normal rivers, magnetic field. And these discussed were distribution of fossil in different continents. This was not discussed. Then, which one of the following is the type of plate boundary of Indian along Himalayan mountain? So it is a continent-continent convergence. Then these are the short type of questions. What were the forces suggested by Wegener for the movement of continents? So Wegener suggested that the movement responsible for the drifting of the continents was caused by pole fleeing force and tidal force. The polar fleeing force relates to the rotation of Earth. The Earth is not a perfect sphere. It has a bulge at the equator. This bulge is due to the rotation of the Earth. The second force, the tidal force, is due to the attraction of the moon and the sun, and that develop tides in motion. What Wegener believed that these forces would become effective when applied over many million years. Then second is, how are the conventional current in the mantle initiated and maintained? So conventional current in the mantle are generated due to radioactive element causing thermal difference in the mantle portion. The hot material rises up from greater depth and comparatively cold material goes down from above. The occurrence of this process repeatedly give birth to conventional current. Then third is, what is the major difference between transform boundary, conversion boundary, divergent boundary? So we will discuss one by one. Firstly, we will discuss transform boundary. So where the crust is neither produced nor destroyed as the plates slide horizontally past each other, that is transform. Then convergent, where the crust is destroyed as one plate dived under another. Conversion, where one plate dived under another. Then divergent, where new crust is generated as the plates pull away from each other. So in convergent, crust is destroyed. In divergent, crust is generated. In transform, no crust is neither generated nor destroyed. Then fourth is, what was the location of the Indian landmass during formation of Deccan Trap? So the Deccan Traps were formed during the movement of Indian plate toward the Asiatic plate. This is started somewhere around 60 million years ago and continued for a long period of time. At that time, Indian landmass was located in the south of the equator. Then long questions, have to write in 150 words. What are the evidence in support of the continental drift theory? So evidence in support of continental drift theory, like First is the matching of continent, jigs of it. The shorelines of Africa and South America facing each other have a remarkable and unmistakable match. Then rock of same age across the ocean, the belt of ancient rock of 2000 million years from Brazil coast matches with those from Western Africa. So the earliest marine deposits along the coastline of South America and Africa are of the Jurassic age. This suggests that ocean did not exist prior to that of time. Then other is it is a sedimentary rock formed out of the deposit of glacier. So the Gondwana system of sediment from India is known to have its counterpart in six different landmasses of the southern hemisphere. So the glacier geloid provides unambiguous evidence of paleoclimate and also of drifting of continent. Then next is placer deposit. So the occurrence of rich placer deposit of gold in Ghana coast and absolute absence of source rock in the region is an amazing fact. The gold bearing veins are in Brazil, and it obvious that gold deposit of Ghana derived from Brazil plateau when the two continents lay side by side. So next is distribution of fossils. So when identical species of plant and animal adapted to living on land or in fresh water are found on either side of the marine barrier, a problem arises regarding accounting for such distribution. So the observation that lemur occur in India, Madagascar and Africa led some to consider contiguous landmass Lemuria, basically linking these three landmasses. Then next is bring about the basic difference between drift theory and plate tectonics. So firstly we discuss drift theory. So drift theory suggested that in the past there was a supercontinent called Pangaea. Over time this supercontinent split apart to form the seven continent we have today. And about plate tectonic. Plate tectonic is a theory of global tectonics which proposes that Earth lithosphere is divided into seven major and some minor plates. Then drift, it only covers the movement of continent. Plate, it covers the movement of both continent and ocean. Then in drift, the evidence in support of drift theory are jigs of it, placer deposit, distribution of fossil in another. Then in plate tectonics, it based on scientific analysis of the process inside the Earth's surface. Then in drift theory, it does not give any future prediction. Plate tectonic, this theory says that all plates shall continue to move in this future period as well. Then next is, what were the major post-drift discovery that rejuvenated the interest of scientists in the study of distribution of ocean and continent? So a number of post-drift discovery during the post-war period added new information to geological literature. Particularly the information collected from the ocean floor mapping provided new dimensions for the study of distribution of ocean and continent. So all along the mid-oceanic ridges, volcanic eruptions are common and they bring huge amount of lava to the surface in this area. So the rock equidistance on either side of the crest of mid-oceanic ridges show remarkable similarity in terms of period of formation, chemical composition, magnetic properties. Rock closer to the mid-oceanic ridge are normal polarity and are the youngest. The age of the rocks increases as one moves away from crust. So the ocean crust rock are much younger than continental rock. The age of rock in the oceanic crust is nowhere more than 200 million years old. The sediment on the ocean floor is unexpectedly very thin. The deep trenches have deep seated earthquake occurrence, while in the mid-oceanic ridge area the quake foci have shallow depth. So we are done with this solution of this chapter also, that is distribution of ocean. That's for today. Thank you.